Now, where is x now? Okay, now we are okay. Well, now we have to read the article. Is it okay? Can you? I'm going to share you the screen, sorry. Okay. Well, let's read the article. And then we have to choose the correct word to complete the gaps there. Let's have a look at the, yes, let's have a look at the vocabulary first. Well, matter or mind, importar. I'm going to show you first. Well, embarrassing or embarrass, what is the difference? Embarrassing is when you refer to a situation. Or a thing. And in the case of embarrass, you refer to a person. Then leave, salir o dejar. It depends on context. Left is permitir. Well, then we have wake and awake. Wake, despertar. That is the verb. And then we have awake, that is the adjective, despierto. That is the difference. Hear, oír, that is the ability. And listen is escuchar. Then we have bad, malo. Wrong, incorrecto. Wrong. Afford and paid. Well, afford is afrontar los gastos. Refiriéndose a los gastos. And pay is pagar. Okay. Realize. Well, here is in the past, or maybe the participle. Well, dado cuenta, se ha dado cuenta, se han dado cuenta. Ay, cuenta, no cuenca. No pinche. Well, then, conocido o sabido, known. Depends on context. Then removed, retire. Remove is retirar something. For example, remove the clothes. ¿Sabes? Retirarte, sacarte la ropa. Sacar, retirar. And the other that is retire is, for example, when you refer to a person, jubilarse. Retirarse, in that sense. Notes and bills. Well, notes are billetes, the notes. And bills are cuentas, that you have to pay. La factura, la, que tengo que pagarla. So, matter. Importar o mind, it depends. Embarrassing and embarrassed. Well, embarrassing is for a situation. Embarrassed when you refer to a person. And the verb to embarrass that is not there, que no está ahí, es avergonzarse. Avergonzante, avergonzado. Well, wake is leave, salir, dejar, let, permitir. Wake is the verb, despertar. Awake is the adjective, despierto. Here is refers to the ability, oír, and listen is escuchar. Well, bad, malo, the opposite of bad is wrong, incorrecto. Afford, afrontar, for example, gastos, pay, pagar. Realized, he dado cuenta. Known, conocido, sabido. Remote, sacar, retirar, something. And retire, jubilarse y retirarse. So this the second option refers to people. Well, notes and bills. Notes, billetes, okay. Bills, facturas, cuentas. Okay, so we are done. Now, yes. Okay, I'm going to start reading you. It says, things you know if you still live with your parents. In the UK, 25% of young adults aged between 20 to 34 still live at home with their parents. This has gone up, that is increased, incrementado, gone up. By 20% in the last 20 years. So what are the pros and cons? Cons, bueno, pros y contras. Cons, contras. Pros y las contras. Bueno, downside, that is the bad side, lo malo. I'm going to take a screenshot of the introduction. And we are going to read. ¿Cómo? I'm going to take a screenshot of this part, Mayri, that is the introduction, and then we are going to read one and one. Okay. I'm going to read with you.
Okay.
You read one, I read another one like this. Let's see, Mayri. Okay, the downside. Okay, read the first part and then we check. It doesn't. Yes, that's number one.
It doesn't.
Then we say.
It doesn't how old or all you are.
You'll. No. Yes, you'll. You'll.
You'll always be a child. To
child.
Them. To they'll. Them. Ah, child.
To yes, them. It's okay. It's okay, my.
They'll tell you to put a coat. Coat.
Coat
is it?
Coat. Coat.
On air. Coat. On every time you leave. The house.
Well, it doesn't. No, let's check that one, Mayri. It doesn't, I know, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how old you are, you always be a child to them. So we have to write matter, Mayri. Coat, saco, you tell me, coat, saco. Leave, salir, you leave the house, salir de la casa. They'll tell you to put on a quote every time you leave the house. Okay, read the next one. It's really.
It's really when you meet new people to admit.
You. Yes, you.
You are still sleeping.
Still sleeping. You're
still sleeping in your childhood
bedroom. Okay, it's really, let's check. It's really, it's a situation. So it's really embarrassing.
Embarrassing.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, embarrassing. It's really embarrassing. Oh. Let's see. Admit. Admit is admitir. Well, here, when you have you plus the verb to be with a contractive form, as in this case, the pronunciation is you.
Childhood.
Ah, childhood. Infancy. I'm going to write you. Don't worry. You ask me. Ask me. Vos pregunto. Childhood. I'm going to write everything. Yo voy a poner el espacito todo. Childhood is infancia. Still aún, Okay, read the next one, Mighty. You have to.
You have to then ignore all.
Yes, it's okay.
Movements. Okay. And text them to say your. Sería your
excellent.
You're going to be home late.
Fantastic. Movements. Movements are movimientos. Movements. Well, text to send a message. Mandar un mensaje. Mensajearlos. Text them. So you have to, let's check, Mary. You have to, well, leave or let. No, leave them, let them know. Hacerlos saber, notificarlos que vas. Let know, in this case, let them know. Avisarles, sería let, no, then no, avisarles.
Sería como avisarles.
Claro. You're going to, okay. You tell me, Mighty. Well, then, this 99%.
99% of the time after a night out. Your parents will be
don't worry,
waiting for
you.
And if it's
for a.m.
o'clock.
Yes, I am.
Okay.
Yes, it's okay. Let's see the vocabulary. Well, parents, even if, aún si, even if, aún si, even if. So 90% of the time after night out, your parents will be awake. They will be awake because this is the answer. So what I'm going to do is to take a screenshot of this part. There. Okay, memory. Let's see. Okay, now I'm going to paste the what follows. And let's have a look at the next part. Okay, really, Mighty. Every day.
Yeah. Every day of your life, you.
Don't worry.
Treat this house like treat.
Mm-hmm.
Like a
hotel. Very good. Treat. Tratas. Treat, very good. Well, every day of your life, you hear or you listen. Well, you hear. Claro, you hear. Exactly. You hear. Mm-hmm. You treat this house like a hotel. Typical of it. Well, okay. The typical one. Okay. Well, okay, I'll read the next one, don't worry. You become?
Yeah. You become the household
IT.
IT.
Technician. El que lo relato.
Technician.
If anything.
Okay, technician, if anything goes
mm-hmm.
in the house to with phones, broadband, or TV.
Your call.
Broadband or TV, you are
called
to the
rescue. To rescue. Bueno, here we have. Well, household de la casa. IT, well, IT is information technology. So, información. Ay, no llega la cámara. Bueno, no importa. I'm going on. Sigamos, no importa. You become the household IT technician. Would be la técnica de la técnica La técnica, bueno, sí, de la tecnología. Suena bien, pero es eso. Bueno, if anything goes wrong, si algo sale mal, it goes wrong, sale mal. And how to do with phones. Ah, broadband. Broadband is banda ancha, la banda ancha de internet.
Ah, sí, no me acuerdo.
No, no, I don't know if we say, no sé si lo vimos eso.
Sí, lo vimos, pero
¿Sí?
no me acuerdo.
Ah,
En algún
bueno.
momento lo vimos, sí.
Ah. Your call, bueno, te llaman para el rescate. Your call to the rescue. Going to rescue there. Okay. Well, but on the other hand, bueno, pero por otra parte, on the other hand, por otra parte.
Bien. The weekends you make up with the smell of
Bacon
bacon and eggs.
and eggs. Very good. Smell, olor, con el
De
olor. Ah, sorry.
olor.
I'm going to tell you just in case, Mary. Bacon
Sí, voy a leer
is,
el otro porque.
sí, smell of bacon. Bacon es tocino, panceta.
Sí, como la panceta.
Sí, exactly, and
Y de
eggs.
cabeza
Ok,
dice.
go. Sí, o
Bacon.
bacon, exactly. The fridge, ok, go on reading, Mary. De bacon, de
The
fridge, no de bacon. At Cadbury's. Yes, de bacon.
fridge and cupboard always have something in them, and it's generally a lot better
Than
than
you
you could.
could. A ver, let's see. Now you could realized. ¿Darse cuenta o no? A ver. The fridge and the
No,
cardboard,
las
or
el
cardboard,
siete.
it's number seven. Let's see, I'm going to check. Ah, afford or pay are the options. Or pay. Well, the fridge and cardboard always has something that you could afford. Exactly. It's afford. Excellent, mighty. Okay, let's take a screenshot of this other part. Okay, and now I paste it. Mary, give me a moment.
Ay, Cami puso que no llegaba.
Sí, recién vi. Bueno, I go on recording. Sigo grabando y listo. Porque si no, no puede.
Sí.
Se va a retrasar. Okay, so let's see the app. Bueno, voy a leer. Sí. Cuando dice, bueno. Maybe what we can do all the activities is say the speaking, and then when you are together, we do the speaking. Dejamos el speaking para cuando están juntos y listo.
Para después.
Claro, y listo,
No
se
hay
pueden
problema.
ver bien entre las dos. Ok, well, let's go on reading. Oh, you have to read a lot. Okay, you tell me. If not, I read
No
part of
pasa
you,
nada.
si no te leo un poco yo. Don't worry. There's nothing better.
There's nothing better than home cooking
Cooked, that
food
is cooked
and
for
cook
food.
food and
Lo you'd
that
that
you'll
never
never
be able to.
able to cook
Well,
as well as your parents.
parents. Okay, a ver, let's see. It's
Parents.
number A, ¿o no? Yes. Realize o no. A ver. Never, there is something better that you than home cooked food and you realized, te das cuenta, realized something to comer. Home cooked food, comida casera. Home cooked food. Going to write it there. Ay. Yes, it was okay because it goes on with realized. you also realized?
You also realized that your mom has
magical, yes.
Magical laundry
powers.
Laundry powers that
all the stains. The stains, las manchas, don't worry. That remove, claro, that remove. Don't worry, maybe we don't know this. And here also I didn't tell you, Mayri, as well as your parents, they are on the previous bullet point, también combo, pero, as well as. Well, magical laundry powers. Well, laundry limpieza, de lavado, o sea, poderes mágicos para lavar. Sería una cosa así. Laundry is lavado. When you refer to clothes, powers is
claro.
Poderes. Stains, sí. Stains are manchas. Manchas, Mayri. Now I like it. Because, yes, we have a lot of vocabulary there also. So it's, that's why.
Or you're washing and make it super clean,
exactly. So it's, I cannot write it, sorry. Yeah. Stains, manchas.
Remove,
exactly. Fantastic. Remove. Yes. Well, the pronunciation there is, sometimes it's like frozen. Okay, stains. Super clean, well, super clean. Well, then, it says, you have no idea.
You have no idea
how much
cost. In fact, you didn't
even know until recently
that
you
had to pay for water.
Exactly.
Water.
You have no idea how much. That is number, let's see. Yeah, number 10. How much knows or bills? Bills. How much bill?
Yes.
Okay. Then is what are the options we take? Say bills. Bills or no? Is it? Cost. Bueno, well, let's see. Until hasta. Recently, recientemente. Well, I'm going to read you the end, don't worry. But before reading you the end, I'm going to take a screenshot of that part. It was quite long. Okay, and now let's see the last part of it. I'm going to take this to the dog. Well, let's see together, Mike. Well, I'm going to read you the conclusion. So, despite how much you complain about still living with your parents, you know perfectly well that they allowed you to save money. You have somewhere nice to live for far less than the cost of renting elsewhere, and they fill your stomachs with good food. And for that, you're eternally grateful. Well, so entonces, despite, a pesar de, entonces, so this is the conclusion, despite, complain, quejar, quejarse. Parents, you know perfectly well that they allowed you, te ha permitido save money. No, no, no. You have somewhere, nice. Somewhere, alguna parte, somewhere. To live for far less, por mucho menos que el costo. For far less, notice this expression. Del costo de entrar en cualquier parte. And they fill your stomach. Te llenan la panza, ¿sí? Con buena comida. They fill your stomach. Estómago. Beautiful. And for you, you're eternally grateful. Y por eso le estás eternamente agradecido. Well, we have it done. Something to comment on the pronunciation is about this. When you have this sound, that is always "I'd" when you have this. So it's despite. There is complain. That is difficult. So complain. Well, parents perfectly here. Yes, perfectly. Well, allowed. Say money somewhere to live for less because of renting elsewhere. And fill your stomachs. Be careful with food. You're eternally, we say, grateful. Okay, let's take a screenshot of that part, Mary. That it was quite long. Bastante larguito. And now, let's see what follows. Give me a moment and I'm going to do this to take you to the next part. Okay, let's go to next page. That is page 71. Well, this one was done. Well, what we can skip is letter F. I'm going to, because you can do it, then you can do it with Kami. And I'm going, letter F, I'm going to circle it to remember. Well, and then we are going
igual
to...
Igual yo la semana que viene no voy
a... no, so bueno, let's take a screenshot. No, let's take a screenshot and we do it, you practice it with me. Don't worry. Yes, I forgot that you told me, me olvidé que me había...
Yes.
Okay, so don't worry, because what we are going to do is like this. Let's record the screen and then you have the video. Yes, this is what I do for school. This is it. Not the whole class, but sometimes the explanation. So. Okay. So now, Mighty, I'm going to take you to to the dock, and we are going to do it together. Well, let's see the question. So. What percentage of young people age from 20 to 34 do you think live with their parents in your country? Well, I think, I don't know the percentage. Maybe now the cost of living is high now. So maybe,
sí, acá sí.
Yes, sí, and it happens in Euro nowadays. In Euro is the same, in Spain, for example, it's the same. So I think that maybe, I don't know, 70%,
sí.
For
sí.
Sure, I think, percentage or percentages, it says here, that is the same. of them, or of young people if you prefer, live with their parents because of the cost of living. Costo de vida. Well, are the Dennis says, let's see. Are the pros and cons similar in your country? Well, yes. Well, same as here, yes. I think yes. Yes, they are. Yes, we have the same problems. It's the same. Well, which two advantages and two disadvantages do you think are the most important? Well, well, as regards advantages, claro, as regards advantages, we can say that you don't have to pay a rent. That is quite pay a rent, and also you share the bills. That is quite expensive nowadays. Well, and the two disadvantages, well, as regards disadvantages, and now we are going to practice it. Y ahora lo vamos a practicar. Entonces, so, as regards disadvantages, advantages, advantages, we can say that yes, the things that were mentioned in the text, claro, that you have to well, let's go back to that. Well, the other hand, well, and you can weekends, requirements, well, every day, the trio have a hotel. Well, then your parents will be away. Well, that your parents will be waiting for you.
Yes, sir.
That your parents will be will waiting for you late at night, and that, and let's take another one that should be important also. Let's see, like your parents with another moment. Well, that they know all your movements. I don't know if it is a disadvantage. Well, they will tell you what to do. Put your coat, put, yes. Maybe that they'll or they will, let's use will, tell you what to do every time. I don't know. Okay, so, well, and the last one, how do you think parents feel about having their children living home? Well, they feel, maybe as they say, they are for their young children, well, they feel grateful because they have them at home. at home, they maybe they think they are still children, think that they can rule them, or that they yeah. Well, that's all. Well, now we practice it. Well, now I ask you, Mary. You tell me if you're okay. Let me see.
Te pregunto.
You ask me, yes, one and one. Let's do. Okay, you ask me one and
okay. Okay.
What percentage?
Percentage of young people age 20
to from 20 to 34.
¿Cómo se dice igual?
From 20.
From 20
to 34. Do you
think, like
live
with the parents?
Parents somewhere in your country. Very good. I think 70% of them live with their parents because of the cost of living. Now I ask you the next one. Are the pros and cons similar in your country?
Yes,
they are. Okay. Now you ask me, Mighty. Which two advantages? You ask me. Which advantages, don't worry. And disadvantages, excellent. Disadvantages.
Disadvantages, do you think are the most important?
Very good. And regarding advantages, we can say that they don't have to pay a rent and share the bills. Not you, but it's not you there. Okay. As regards disadvantages, we can say that your parents will waiting for you. Yes, another mistake. Will be waiting for you late at night, and they will tell you what to do every time. Well, now I ask you, how do you think parents feel about having their adult children living at home?
They feel grateful because they have them at home, and they think that they can rule them.
With us, it's more than enough. Fantastic, Mighty. Okay, now we go on. I think everything's recording well, let's hope. Well, now we are going to continue with the book with exercise two. It says, second conditional, choosing between conditionals. Well, first let's see, and then I'm going to explain the conditionals. Well, we have emails there. Yes, it says, Risa comments posted in response to the article in one. That is the article that we read. Do they want to leave their parents home? Why or why not? Well, we have Vivian at, remember that this is said, we say at Montreal, Canada. What he says, I know there's a good side, but all I want is somewhere that's my own, where I can do what I want, where I can have my own furniture and pictures, where no one can tell me what to do. If I had the money, I'd move out immediately. Well, there's a good side. Un lado positivo. Sería. Un lado bueno, un lado positivo. Ahora voy a saber that's my own, que sea mío. Can do what I want, I have my own. Furniture, muebles. Furniture. Let's try the pronunciation because this is difficult. Is furniture. Furniture. Well, pictures, cuadro, pictures. Yes, pictures. Well, no one can tell me what to do. If I had the money, si tuviese el dinero, I move out. Me mudaría immediately. Inmediatamente. So she, does she want to live with her parents? No, not at all, definitely. She wants, yeah, she wants to have her own furniture, her own pictures, and her own rules, let's say. So, well, now we have Marcus at Naples, Italy. I'm perfectly happy living with my parents. If I lived on my own, I'd have to pay rent and do the housework. Yes, and the cooking. That's right. Here, somebody else cooks and cleans. I have a nice room. Why would I want to leave? Even if I could afford it, I couldn't move out. Not until I get married. Well, I
have to pay.
No, but no, this wants to stay at home forever. So, yes, this one, no. Well, the vocabulary, no. No, not until, no after. So, the rent, house, we're cooking, clean, somebody, no. Well, and then we have Andrea at Melbourne, Australia. It isn't that my parents aren't good to me. They are. If they weren't, I couldn't live with them. But I'm 29 and I just don't feel independent. So she wants to leave because she wants to be free. She wants to be independent. Okay, so I'm going to take a screenshot of that part. And let's see. The next one, that is the last one, Carlos. This is me, Mr. Carlos. Let's see what it says. Carlos at Valencia, Spain. I'd love to move out. Another one. I get on well with my parents, but I think I get on with them even better if I didn't live at home. My mom drives me mad. If it isn't her fault, she does, but she does. And I really like to have a dog, but my mom is allergic to them. Well, here the problem is that it's about her mom that drives him mad, yes. And she's also allergic to dogs, and he would like to have dog. Mm-hmm. It isn't her fault. Fault is culpa. Fault, we say. It isn't her fault, no es su culpa. Yes. I think the rest is okay. It's fault. Ah, dry mad is volver loco, alguien. It's very colloquial. It's like crazy, but more colloquial. Dry mad, volver loco. Yes. Any other thing? Well, allergic to, alérgico a. Alérgico. Allergic. Get them well, but yes, that's all. Tell me, Mighty, if you see another word or anything.
Sí.
Okay, let's see. What I'm going to paste is there. What so? No, I'm going to paste you this side. Here we are. Well, let's go. Well, to be. He says, now answer the questions with a partner. Well, I'm going to take a screenshot because it's impossible to answer there. Okay, and I'm going to paste it in the doc. and take you there. Okay, now I'm going to share screen with you there. Well, so in the highlighted phrases, here we have the highlighted phrases are, if I lived on my own, I have to pay rent. If I could afford it, I wouldn't move out. If they weren't, I couldn't live with them. I get get on with them even better if I didn't live at home. So, what tense is after if? Well, first let's talk a bit about the conditional. Well, this is the second conditional that we are going to revise it a bit. A conditional. Well, this is when it is something possible but non-probable to happen. Maybe because they can afford to live on their own. So it's not probable that this happened, but maybe in the near future, yes. Okay, so non-probable. So in the second condition is like this. We have if the subject, as you can see there, if I didn't live at home. So, if I weren't, if I could, so is followed by the past simple. The past simple is the second conditional. And the other clause is always subject. And then we have good. Or the contractive form, and in case it is negative, is wouldn't. Now I'm going to provide you an example. An infinitive verb. Now I show you. Now I'm going to show you my, for example, if. Let's take examples there. Yes, if they weren't, I couldn't live with them. For example, if they weren't, I couldn't live with them. Well, this is one of the highlighted phrases that you have there. So first, the if clause is always in the past simple past, and the other is with good, either positive or negative plus infinitive. Well, what it is not there in the book, but I'm going to explain to you that I don't know if you remember this, is that if we had the verb to be in the second conditional, is always were not was. For example, if I could, I were you, see for, no was, if I were, so it's always were. If I were you, for example, let's say this, I'd live with my parents, for example. So, when you had the verb to be, we use were. Was is never used in the second conditional. It's always were. Well, and I think, well, what form is the other verb? As we saw, is we good. This is already, we have already answered it. Then three says, do the phrases to phrases refer to a situation that will probably happen soon, or a situation that they are imagining? No, it is something that will happen soon. It's not probable now, but it will happen soon. So the answer is letter A. So yes, let's see if we have a bullet point. Yes, 3A. So it's A. Well, that's all.
Right.
Well, this is all there. So now I'm going to take you, I think, to the activity. You tell me, Mary.
See?
Well, this is okay. Yes, then, well, then we have a listening that we are going to do it, and then we go to the activity book. So I'm going to prepare you the listening that is 7.60. There. So now we have to listen. Now I'm going to show you. 7.16 or 7. Oh, yeah, I forgot it. 16. Yes, it was 16. It was okay. There it is. Now I share it with you, Mighty.
7.16.
First, I'm going to show you the exercise in the book. So it says, listen and repeat the sentences. Copy the rhythm. Well, as you can see, the content words, that is to say the most important words, that we call them content words, are always stressed. Siempre se sentan en duelo, la palabra importante. Well, it says, if I live to my own, I have to pay rent. If you get a mortgage, you buy the house. A mortgage is hipoteca.
Yes.
Hipoteca. Okay, be careful. Because that one is difficult. Hipoteca. Mortgage. Mortgage. Well, then it says, would you leave home if you got a job? I won't move out if I can't afford it. If it were my flat, I'd be happy to do the cleaning. Here, you can also see this. Here we have the verb to be, but as it is in the second conditional, is were not was. Now we are ready to listen to it. Here we go. I'm going to share this. You, let's listen.
One.
Wow.
If I lived on my own, I'd have to pay rent.
Two. If we get a mortgage, we'll buy the house.
Three.
Would you leave home if you got a job?
Four.
I won't move out if I can't afford it.
Five.
If it were my flat, I'd be happy to do the cleaning.
Okay, let's listen to you once
more. 7.16. One.
If I lived on my own, I'd have to pay rent.
Two.
If we get a mortgage, we'll buy the house.
Three.
Would you leave home if you got a job?
Four.
I won't move out if I can't afford it.
Five.
If it were my flat, I'd be happy to do the cleaning.
Okay. Well, now we are going to the activity book. A moment, then I'm going to take you there. Here we go. Okay, I'm going to share screen with you, Mighty. Here we go. Okay, now we see. I have to travel with some. There is. Okay. Well, let's check the page, Mighty. That is page, I think, I'm going to bring you because 40, this was done, 47, we have to do the last one, that is I finish exercise free, that is with the first condition.
El tres no hicimos.
Claro, free. Exercise free, exactly. That is with the conditionals because we didn't see them. Well, it says, match the sentence half. Well, so, for example, will you buy a car if you pass your driving test? Then it says, two. My experience will be furious. So let's see. Unless he revises more, no. After I come back from my holiday, no. If he fails his exam again, yes, let us see. Must be. For sure. Well, three says, I have more time to help you. Well, and he says, unless he revises, no. After I come back from my holiday, maybe. I finished that one. Then we have to check, but I think yes. You have to go to a new school. Well, when your family moves house, must be that one for sure. Then he won't pass his exams unless he revises more. That is letter A. This is what I always tell them. My students, okay. Nina won't go back to work. Until her daughter maybe start school. Yes. I'm not sure. Before the classes start. Yes, they don't. So Nina won't go back to work. Well, we use B is done. Well, let's stick the ones that we have already used. Well, A, yes. B, done. C, done. E, that is the example, is done. So we have use all them. So Nina won't go back to work before the classes start. When your family, no, because this is I, F, no. If I, no. So the possibilities are before the classes start or until her daughter starts school. Well, I think until her daughter starts school because... It's a mother, no. The other, no. I think it's an adult, so must be that one. H. You'll need to buy the book. Exactly, before the classes start. Yes, for sure. Right. I'll stay home. If I still don't feel well in the morning, yes, it's perfect. But sometimes you have to check because you have more than one possibility. And sometimes more than one is okay, but for other ones, no. So you don't have to take this for granted. So let's, okay, with this, we are done, Mighty. And now, I have such challenges. And now let's go to next page. I'm pasting you everything. Okay, where do I have you there? There. Okay. So let's have a look at page 48. No, yes. Well, here we have all these. Yes, we have to complete sentences when they were from the list. Well, this is what all we have seen today. Well, we have after. Luego, before, antes, if, see, that is the condition, unless, a menos que, this is the condition, until, hasta, when is, cuando. For example, they won't be able to leave school unless the teacher gives them permission. Be able to, or will be able to, será capaz. Won't in the negative, no, serán capaces, no pondrán, será, no podrán en el futuro, no podrán. En este caso, salir de la escuela, abandonar la escuela, a menos que la profesora les dé permiso. Then, they will have to wear a uniform. They go to when they go to secondary school. Exactly. I told to my teachers, before I choose my exam subjects, must be subjects materias. I'm going to write it just in case. Hila will be disappointed, desilusionada. Disappointed. She doesn't get good mark. If, get good marks, obtener buenas notas. Get good marks, obtener buenas notas. I'll have a long holiday after the course finishes. After the course finishes. The teacher won't start the class before all pupils are quiet. En silencio. Quiet en silencio. Well, I'm going to take a screenshot of this. You tell me, Mighty, if we go too quick.
Sí, sí.
Okay. Fantastic. Sometimes it's not easy to follow all that so quickly. Okay, and now we are going to check out C, where we have present with future. These are the conditions. Well, we didn't see them in the student's book, but I'm going to explain this. It's very easy. I'll show you my. We call them. Well, these are called. We have some connectors that I'm going to show you. When we have as soon as, unless, before, general, well, this is the first conditional, until, unless, I'm going to underline all this to show you, as soon as, well, until, better if, well, let's see, well, for example, you have to use present simple or future we will or won't. It says, I'll do my homework as soon as, tan pronto como. As soon as, tan pronto como. Well, after some connectors such as soon as, we have present simple. So as soon as plus present simple. It's always the same. Present simple, that is verb with s, or no s, or doesn't or don't, and the verb. So, present simple is after, as soon as, present simple. And the other one is future, always. Future, we will, either in the positive or negative. So, as soon as, present simple, yes, well, unless we lay a menos que we, well, the same. After unless is present simple always. So, will be late unless we hurry. Well. Well, in that case, it's different. Before, that is, antes. Here you say have and go out. I'll have the same, lo mismo. I'll have a shower before I go out. So what you know, have to know is that after the, these connectors, after as soon as, unless, and before, you use present simple always. Well, the school bus won't wait for us. Well, this is the first condition. If you aren't on time. Well, this is first conditional, that you know, in the first conditional, we always have a if clause is using present simple. Well, that if the teacher doesn't come, here is different. So after this if clause, we have present simple. That's here. So what happens here is that if we start with if here. Acá empezamos. Entonces, if the teacher doesn't come. Almost finishing, perdón, ya terminamos, me di cuenta. Doesn't come, we won't have the exam. So, the clause with if is always present simple, and the other is with future. Bueno.
Okay.
James. Well, the same. James won't leave home. Until he finds a job. The same. So after until, the thing we're going to see is present simple. It's always the same. Well, here the same. We have unless. So present future and present simple. So Alice won't be able to buy a car unless her parents lend her money. Well, as soon as, present simple. So the clause with as soon as is always followed by present simple. So as soon as my friend gets his results, he'll call me, or he will call me. Well, here we have until. So before, until is present simple, and there is will. So she'll, or she will, she, ah, no, it's negative, sorry.
No, I'm saying
see, won't. She won't start primary school until she's 5 years old. Well, and the last one, well, if the if clause, so you'll play better if you practice more. Every day, no more. Sorry. Okay, that's all, Mighty. So do you understand? So what after when you, claro, the clause we as soon as, unless, before, if, until, or unless is always present simple. And the other clause, la otra, is future, en el futuro. It doesn't matter the position, no importa donde esté. Bueno, I'm going to start recording, lo voy a dejar de grabar.